Hello, my name is Francisco Arriaga. I'm a state specialist with the University of Wisconsin Extension Service.
I'm Jamie Patton. I'm the Shawano County Agriculture Agent with UW Extension. And today we're standing in cover crops near Manawa, Wisconsin. We wanted to highlight some of the importance of having a cover to increase water infiltration as well as water quality, as well improve soil health overall. So Francisco, can you talk about what we're looking at today?
So we have a field that it was in need of having some cover crops that were having some issues with erosion problems. And so having this ground covered is very important to reduce, minimize the raindrop impact and keeping that soil where it needs to be and keeping all the nutrients where the future crops can use it. Part of the issue is that we're near a lake that, you know, some of these issues can be quite visible, but we have this situation in other parts of the state. So, but there's other benefits to the cover crop. There's different species of cover crops out there. So one of the things we want to highlight is the variety of different cover crops we have, the different root structures, and you know, maybe where some of these could be suitable and where, you know, could work for you.
So as you can see from behind us, we have several different plots of different species. And so this was part of a field day that was held here in Waupaca County. So the first thing I want to point out was some of the clovers. And I'll have Francisco hold this for me. And so when you'll notice the clovers, we have a beautiful root structure. These have only been in the ground for a little over a month and a half. And as we'll see a little later, as we zoom into these clover roots, we can see that there's nodulation already. So these clovers are already fixing nitrogen for the next crop. So in addition to adding organic matter through this incredible root system and to increasing microbial activity, increasing nitrogen content, we're also seeing some compaction alleviation due to this tremendous root growth. In addition, out here, you'll see a lot of barley. And so barley, particularly spring barley here in northern Wisconsin, is used quite a bit as a good cover because we get incredible biomass growth even in our short growing season. And you can see it typical of a grass plant. We get good fibrous root system. And as Francisco was talking about, this fibrous root system does a great job of holding soil in place and helping us to keep this soil out of the nearby lake. In addition, much like those clovers, we're getting tremendous root growth, which are helping to build organic matter content as well as alleviate compaction. And in particular, in the grass plants, we're getting some nutrient sequestration, meaning that nitrogen, that phosphorus, that potassium is being held in that plant and can be recycled next growing season. And you'll see I have several brassicas in my arms as well. And so we have some turnips. So here in northern Wisconsin, we really like turnips in that we get good above ground growth that's high in crude protein, so they're good to graze. In addition, after frost, these bulbs turn sugary, and you'll see cattle love to graze on them, as well as many of our wildlife species up here. So as deer season approaches, you're gonna see a lot of hunters planting some of these brassicas as a cover, as well as a place to hunt over. In addition, we have a lot of radishes out here. And so you'll notice all of our radishes are fairly small. These are all been part of a mix. I personally like to see them nice and small, and I'm gonna point out this radish in particular. What I wanna highlight is all of that tremendous lateral growth off of those roots. So all of those side roots coming off of that tap root. This is helping to increase organic matter contents as well as helping to alleviate compaction. When we look at radishes, again, a lot of farmers will graze these. They can be, in particular, if you plant a forage type radish, a good grazing, good grazer, particularly in a mix. And Francisco, you wanted to highlight the importance of having radishes in a mix.
Yep. So Jamie, you talked about soil compaction earlier, and you know, radishes are a good option for helping with that, with their root system. You mentioned the lateral mm-hmm. roots, also adding the organic matter, as you said earlier. But one issue that we sometimes see with radishes in areas that are prone to erosion is that when these winter kill, they'll leave perforations or even the radish being there, and water will kind of flow around it preferentially. And so we see cases where we see erosion caused around the edges of where the radish, a single radish plant, is. So one thing that we like to recommend is actually to plant the radishes, if you can, in a mix with something with a fibrous root system, like Jamie was talking about, you know, something like this barley or a clover or something that has a nice fibrous system. This, as you can see, these fibrous roots are really good at holding that soil together and protecting that soil. And they're also adding tremendous amounts of organic matter. Plus the smaller roots are also helping penetrate compacted layers and adding some biodiversity to the soil and helping the biology of that soil to break the compaction.
As always, Francisco would probably agree, our first option is always to identify our goal. So what are you actually growing cover crops for? Is it for erosion protection? Is it for organic matter? Is it for nutrient sequestration? Is it for grazing? You need to first identify what you want your cover crops to do, and then we can talk about species selection, because each species has its own benefit as well as its own challenges. For more information on cover crops, contact your local county UW Extension office.
Or alternatively, we also have now a new resource, the University of Wisconsin Extension cover crop website, listed below.